he's acting.
The soldiers march. Down a hot and dusty road tramps a soldier with his load. 10 days leave he has to spend. Will his journey never end? Marching home, marching on his way, marching, marching on the day. Soon he will be home to stay. The soldier comes to the banks of a stream. He opens his knapsack and takes out some treasures, a lucky medallion, a picture of his fiancée, and finally, an old brown fiddle. It didn't cost much, the tone's not rich. You have to keep screwing it up to pitch.
Thank you.
The devil appears, disguised as an old man carrying a butterfly net. The devil convinces the soldier to trade his violin for a magic book that reveals the secrets of how to become rich. The soldier agrees to spend 3 days at the devil's home. There, while enjoying the finest food, wine, and cigars, the soldier teaches the devil how to play the violin. The devil in turn reveals the secrets of the book. After 3 days have passed, the soldier once again begins his journey home. The devil escorts the soldier in magic carriage. Higher and higher over valley and hill, faster and faster, up and up they soar till time stands still. Then everything is as it was before. Finally, the soldier arrives at his village, but none of his friends recognize him. The soldier's mother shrieks at his approach. The soldier discovers that his fiancée is married and is the mother of 2 children. And then the soldier realizes that the devil has tricked him. The soldier has not been gone for 3 days. 3 years have passed. The devil reappears, this time disguised as a cattle merchant. He watches as the soldier complains. I should have had my suspicions, but no, I listened to the devil. Like a fool, I had to go and listen to him and gave him my fiddle, of all the luck. And now, what am I going to do? What am I going to do now? When the soldier sees the devil, he pulls out his sword. But at the devil's command, the soldier halts. The devil reminds the soldier of their trade, the magic book for the violin. This is mine here, that is yours there, each his own, and so all's square. The soldier uses the secrets of the magic book to become rich, but the young man realizes that for all his wealth, he has nothing. Oh, to have still the things you had before, the real, the true, good things that everybody has but you, that you have no more, the only things worth having, just to stretch out in the grass as you used to do, good to touch. Good to feel, things that cost nothing, that everyone has, that means so much. These things are real, things that belong to all the world but you. Saturday evening, weekend plans, watching the village at work in its garden, so many people with watering cans, the little girls playing Tom Tiddler's ground, you smile. As you pass along the sun-baked wall, you settle down on the grass, and someone fills your glass. Things that are warm inside, the only ones worth having. The soldier is sitting at his desk, thumbing through the book. The devil appears, disguised as an old woman. She offers her wares. The soldier refuses until the devil shows him the violin. But the soldier grabs the violin and tries to play. The instrument doesn't make a sound. The soldier throws the violin away. He picks up the book and tears it into 1,000 pieces. In a distant land and goes to an inn. He learns that the king's daughter is ill. The princess lies in bed and doesn't sleep, speak, or eat. The king proclaims that the man who cures his daughter shall marry the beautiful princess. The soldier bangs his fist on the table. Why not? He exclaims, he's up. He's off and makes his way to the palace gates. He gives a ring. Where are you going? The sentries say. Where am I going? To see the king. Soldier to see the princess. While the soldier waits in his room, the devil appears dressed as a virtuoso violinist. The soldier challenges the devil to a game of cards. The devil wins every hand, and the soldier loses his entire fortune. But because the soldier is now penniless, the devil has lost all power over him. The soldier pours several glasses of wine down the devil's throat. The soldier subdues the devil and grabs his violin. Once again, the soldier is able to play. Oh, it's like that. All right then, 8, 9, 10. Now take back your own again.
Thank you.
soldier enters the princess's room. The princess is lying on her bed and doesn't move. The soldier begins to play his violin. Finally, the princess sits up. She gets out of bed and begins to dance.
Thank you.
This time dressed as the devil. The princess hides behind the soldier who takes out his violin and begins to play. The devil, forced to dance against his will, finally collapses. The soldier and the princess drag the devil away. Then the lovers fall into each other's arms. Seek to add to what you have, what you once had. You have no right to share what you are with what you were. Can have it all, that is forbidden. You must learn to choose between. Thing is every happy thing. Two is as if they had never been. everything, he thinks. I always will have everything, he thinks. But one day she says, I know so little about you still. Tell me about yourself. Come on, tell me. A long, long time ago, there was a cottage I used to share with my mother. I was a soldier then, you know. Far, far away. I've almost forgotten where. The soldier agrees to take the princess to his village, but while on his way, the soldier encounters the devil dressed in a magnificent scarlet costume. The devil has the violin once again, and he begins to play. The devil waves the soldier on. The soldier, unable to resist, follows.